In this video, I'll show you how to make the upper tunic and hood. For this tutorial, I will use off-white and blue fabric. I start off by laying down the blue fabric and using a template for the upper tunic I made. I made two copies onto the fabric. Then I lay down the off-white fabric and cut out the borders for the tunic and the hood parts. Just like the blue shapes for the tunic, I cut out two copies of each part. I will make each part of the costume dual layer to give it some strength and volume. You can make everything single layered if you like. First, stack the blue fabric onto each other and sew it together at the top and bottom. Don't sew together the sides yet. Make sure all the rough edges are folded over and in between the two layers. In game, there is a brown edge visible, so use a brown thread to sew the layers together. I used light brown, but you can also choose dark brown if you want. Now stack the white border pieces on top of each other and sew the outside edges together. Don't sew the rest yet. Then get your blue pattern and sew the white borders to the sides. You should sew the blue fabric in between the white border. After the white border is sewn to the tunic, you can fold it over so the sides are meeting in the middle. Now you can sew the top edges together. Once that's done, you can flip the tunic inside out, which is actually the right way out now, leaving a nice clean edge. Next, remove the brown thread from your sewing machine and replace it with an off-white thread. And now you can sew the bottom side of the white border together. After that, the upper tunic is pretty much done and we can move over to the hood portion. So get all your hood shapes and sew them together so you basically get two hoods. You don't really have to worry about rough edges for this step. Once you got your two hood shapes, you can fold one inside out. And now you can basically stick one into the other. And all the rough edges will be in between those layers. And now you can sew the hoods together along the edges that are still open. This time you have to pay attention to the rough edges again. You should end up with a single hood that is dual layered. Because of that, it's a lot stronger and will retain its shape. Now you have to join the hood to the upper tunic, and this part can be a bit tricky. It's easier if you put on your upper tunic and have someone around to help you and position the hood and just look if it looks okay, and then you can just sew it to the upper tunic. Once the hood is sewn on, there is one final step to do, and that's sewing on the brown stripes on the white border. So I cut out some thin dark brown leather pieces and sew them onto the white border using dark brown thread. Note that not all sewing machines are capable of sewing such a thick stack of leather and fabric, so you might want to operate your machine by hand like I do here. That way, if it gets stuck, it won't destroy your needle or something else. Once the brown stripes are sewn on, the upper tunic and hood are done. This was my upper tunic and hood tutorial. Thanks for watching.